فؤادك الأيام فتى.
ضرورة لغوية وعقلية وشرعية.
They don't change the necessity of the linguistic meaning and the logic meaning and the Sharia meaning. It doesn't change it. It will still stand.
فإن من شرب الخمر وسماها ماء.
For example, the one who drinks khamr and he calls it water.
ما شرب إلا خمرا.
He hasn't drank except khamr, however much he claims. Hey?
وعقابه عقاب شارب الخمر.
And his punishment is the punishment of the person who drank khamr. نعم.
ولعله يزيد عقابه
عقابه
عقابه للتدليس والكذب في التسميه.
And maybe ولعله يزيد عقابه للتدليس والكذب في التسمية. He said maybe it will rather increase for that person in terms of punishment. Why? للتدليس. He's doing تدليس to the people. He's taking things out. والكذب. He's lying. في التسمية in the naming. Rather he will take more sin than the one who just drinks خمر. The one who drinks it and calls it water. He's lying and he's doing what? تدليس to the people. نعم.
وقد ثبت في الأحاديث أنه يأتي قوم يشربون الخمر يسمونها يغير اسمها.
نعم. يسمونها بغير اسمها. The Sheikh رحمه الله is saying here, there are authentic narration. And the hadith is narrated by who? Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Abu Dawood, Al-Nasai, Al-Tayalis, Ibn Majah, Al-Bayhaqi. And the hadith is sahih. Al-Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله mentions in his سلسلة أحاديث الصحيحة. And this hadith, wallahi, it is what? وهذا الحديث من دلائل نبوته صلى الله عليه وسلم. This hadith, what does it indicate? That this shows the prophet's prophetic, that he was a messenger sent from Allah and a prophet. Why? Because he knew, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that there are going to come a people who are going to drink khamar and they are going to call it other than its name. They come and they call it khamar, different names. The name khamar is gone. You don't hear it. And this is a قاعدة شيطانية إبليسية. It's a قاعدة set by شيطان عليه لعائن الله المتواترة. May Allah's consistent, continuous destruction and curse be upon him. Ha! This is the first step that he took to fall Adam عليه السلام شجرة الخلد وملك لا يبلى. Eat from this tree, the tree of eternity. What was this tree? The tree of destruction. The tree of عذاب. Wasn't it not? But what did he do? And Shaytan, having done that, and having to succeed in that one he did to Adam alayhi salam, those who have read the Quran still seem to fall in the same plots and plans of Shaytan. And he doesn't even need to change his plans. He uses the same thing. He takes his sister's hijab off, and he tells her to call it freedom of speech. Freedom of what? Freedom of speech, freedom of choice. What does he do? He makes a person sell drug and he makes it call it a name other than its name. They call it what? Food. And names like that. All of that is what? يُسَمُّونَهَا بِغَيْرِ اسْمِهَا. They call it other than its name. If this doesn't make a person become a Muslim, then what will? Interest today. Riba is called interest. كيف interest? And Allah is saying, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِي الصَّدَقَاتِ. Allah is destroying riba, fighting with riba. And Allah is nurturing sadaqat. How can you call something Allah is destroying interest? It doesn't make sense. You see how shaitan plays with the people's minds. Plays with the people's minds. By making the name change. Are you with me? And that's exactly the same. The grave worshippers, what did they say? Awliya. Loving the awliya. When you say, why are you worshipping the grave for? He brings an ayah. La alaqata lahu. There's no relationship with what? The mawridun niza'. Ama mahallun niza'. The place you guys are arguing about. He'll say to you, Allah says in the Quran, ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. هذه أولياء الله. ها. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم. There's no fear on them, and there is no, and they're not going to worry. Hey, what's the ayah got to do with worshiping their graves? See how the محل النزاع, the discussion and the point that you're talking about, one is right and one is left. So this is what Shaytan does. He comes to them from the angle, these are allies of Allah. Allah loves them. من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Had a discussion with one guy a while ago. I said to him, why do you blindfold the A'imah when you know the hadith, there's a hadith in this issue? There's a hadith in this issue. Clear cut ayah or a hadith. You have an hadith in this issue. Clear cut. The Prophet said it. Why are you going to give Abu Hanifa the precedence over the Prophet? Why? You clearly have what? You have clearly got the hadith of the Prophet. Who takes president? Allah says, وَاتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِنْ دُونِي أَوْلِيَا. Follow the evidence. Now you can't follow Abu Hanifa, you have to follow the hadith. كيف? How are you going to give president to Abu Hanifa for? And look how shaitan plays with these people's minds and the way that shaitan draws them. Automatically he jumps to the conclusion, which is what? You what? أبو من عادى لي وليا فقد أذنته بالحرب. Anyone who shows enmity to my awliya, my allies, Allah says in the Hadith al-Qudsi, من عادى لي وليا, anyone who shows enmity and hate towards my awliya, فقد أذنته بالحرب. Allah says, I have come out in war with this person, brother. And then he went on that whole way. This is what? Again, it is exactly what the Prophet ﷺ has said here right now. يُسَمُّونَهَا بِغَيْرِ اسْمِهَا. The matter is taken from its real meaning and what it really means. Now.
وَصَدَقَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ.
And the Prophet told the truth. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said in the hadith, حَدَثَنَا الصَّادِقُ الْمَصْدُوقُ إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ يُجْمَعُ خَلْقُوهُ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ 40 يَوْمَ النُّطْفَةِ. He has told the truth. The one who's truthful and is considered truthful, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has told the truth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course he has.
فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ أَتَى طَوَائِفُ مِنَ الْفَسَقَةِ يَشْرَبُونَ الْخَمَرُ وَيُسَمُّونَهَا نَبِيذًا.
There came a group, طوائف, a group, مِنَ الْفَسَقَةِ, transgressors, wrongdoers, criminals that came, يَشْرَبُونَ الْخَمَرَ, they drink the khamar. What do they do? وَيُسَمُّونَهَا نَبِيذًا, and they called it نَبِيذ. Nabith is a drink that was drunk, that was permissible. Are you with me? Nabith is what? Ha. Like for example, then what did they do now? Ha? I just mentioned it. Do they call alcohol in this country, they call it a name?
Juice.
Ha. They call it juice now. Things like that. Juice is something good. Nabith is a juice. Haqiqatan is a juice. Which the Prophet used to drink. The Sahaba used to drink. Nabi was allowed at the time of the Prophet. You see? But then they came and they took khamar and they called it Nabi. Naam. Naam.
وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ سَمَّى مَا فِيهِ غَضَبُ اللَّهِ وَعُسْيَانُهُ بِالْأَسْمَاءِ الْمَحْبُوبَةِ عِنْدَ السَّمَاعِينَ.
عِنْدَ السَّامِعِينَ.
عِنْدَ السَّامِعِينَ.
And the first person. مَنْ سَمَّى فِيهِ غَضَبُ اللَّهِ. Something which Allah is anger is in it. The first person who called a thing in which Allah is angry with, and it's the disobedience of Allah. He called that thing's names which are loved to the ears. Is who?
Iblis.
Iblis. The first one. Hey, yeah?
لَعَنَهُ اللَّهُ.
May Allah's curse be upon him.
فَإِنَّهُ قَالَ لِأَبِي الْبَشْرِ آدَمْ
عَلَيْهِ. فَإِنَّهُ قَالَ لِأَبِي الْبَشَرِ. He said to the what? He said to the father of human, Adam عليه السلام. What did he say?
يَا آدَمُ هَلْ أَدُلُّكَ عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ وَمُلْكِ لَا يَبَلَى.
Oh Adam, shall I show you عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ, the mount, the tree of eternity. Shall I show you it? وَمُلْكِ لَا يَبْلَى, and a kingdom, huh, that will not perish. Shall I show you it?
فَسَمَّ الشَّجَرَةَ الَّتِي نَهَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى آدَمَ عَنْ قُرْبَانَهَا.
عَنْ قُرْبَانِهَا.
عَنْ قُرْبَانِهَا شَجَرَةَ الْخُلْدِ.
And he called the tree in which Allah prohibited Adam عليه السلام to get close to. عَنْ قُرْبَانِهَا شجرة الخلد. He called it what? The tree of eternity. Why did he do that?
جذبا لطبعه إليها.
So he can bring. جذب means what? It's to bring close. It's to pull. To pull his nature. جذبا is to bring. It's to gain. Because the mind, as a human nature, we love. What do we love? We love kingdom. And we love eternity. So he got out something he knew something our nature likes. So he got us, attracted us with it.
وَهَزًا لِنَشَاطِهِ لِقُرْبَانِهَا.
Why? And so he can move Adam alayhi salatu wasalam's enthusiasm, his energy, his drive to what? To get close to it.
وَتَدْلِيسًا عَلَيْهِ بِالْإِسْمِ الَّذِي
And so he can deceive him with the name
اِخْتَرَعَهُ لَهَا
In which he created for him. وَتَدْلِيسًا عَلَيْهِ بِالْإِسْمِ الَّذِي اِخْتَرَعَهُ لَهَا So he can deceive him, so he can fool him with the name in which he invented. He can fool him with it.
كَمَا يُسَمِّي إِخْوَانُهُ الْمُقَلَّدُونَ لَهُ الْحَشِيشَ
كَمَا يُسَمِّي As they call it, إِخْوَانُهُ His friends, his allies, shaitan. They call it what? الْمُقَلِّدُونَ لَهُ Those who blind follow shaitan and take his path. They call it hashisha. Hashisha is what? It's this one, weed.
بِلَقْمَةَ الرَّاحَةِ
They call it the food of joy.
وكما يسمى الظلمة ما يقبضونه من أموال عباد الله ظلما وعدوانا أدب فيقولون أدب القتل أدب السرقة وأدب
سرقة
وأدب السرقة وأدب التهمة
تهمتي
وأدب التهمة بتحريف اسم الظلم إلى اسم الأدب
And they also say, these are the people, human beings, who are the allies of shaitan and their brothers of shaitan who blind follow him. They're called weed what? بلقمة. لقمة means what? The food of الراحة. The food of joy. So the person eats it and he gets joy, right? He gets what? He enjoys himself. He feels enjoying. وكما يسمي الظلمة And the way the oppressors say, ما يقبضونه من أموال عباد الله The transgressors, the leaders, the harsh, what do they call? The wealth of the people they take. Not only the leaders, but also the general mass. They rob somebody, and what do they call it? وَذُلْمًا وَعُدْوَانًا They call it adaman, etiquette, manners. Meaning, I'm teaching this person manners. That's what they say. فَيَقُولُونَ They say, أَدَبُ الْقَتْلِ The manners of killing. أَدَبُ السَّرِقَةِ The etiquette of stealing. أَدَبُ التُهْمَةِ The etiquette of what? The etiquette of a suspicious. بتحريف اسم الظلم إلى اسم الأدب By distorting the word oppression to the meaning of etiquette. That's what they do.
كما يحرفونه في بعض المقبوضات إلى اسم النفاعة وفي بعضها إلى اسم السياقة وفي بعضها أدب المكاييل والمرازين
Like the way they distort some of the things that are bought and the maqbudat that are sold in asmin nafi'ati. They call it what? It's haram. It's not allowed. So they call it the beneficial. Some of them they call it the siyaqati. Some of them they call it the adabul makayil wal mawazin. The manners of what? And they're stealing people. They're robbing people. So they call it what? The etiquette of the weighing and the scaling. And this is all what?
وكل ذلك اسمه عند الله ظلم وعدوان.
And all of those which they're doing, stealing people's and food and income and money, they're making, oppressing the people. All of them, reality of it is, it's called ظلم and عدوان. It's oppression and it's evil.
كما يعرف من
كما يعرفه
كما يعرفه من شم رائحة الكتاب والسنة.
Like he knows the one who smells the fragrance of the Kitab and Sunnah.
وكل ذلك مأخوذ عن إبليس.
All of that methodology is taken from Iblis to call something a name different to its name.
حيث سمى الشجرة المنهية عنها شجرة الخلد.
Like Iblis did. He called the tree that was prohibited, what did he call it? شجرات الخلد, he called it. نعم.
وكذلك تسمية القبر مشهدا
And calling the grave today a مشهد. Like a museum, a place you go and you check.
ومن يعتقدون فيه وليا.
The person who they believe in, they call him a ولي. They don't want to call this an idol, but they call it a ولي. ولي of Allah we're going to.
لا يخرجه عن اسم صنمي والوثن.
صنمي
والوثن.
But the reality is that the matter doesn't leave it being a what? A salam and a wathan. Believe it.
إذ هم معاملون لها معاملة المشركون لأصنام ويطوفون بهم طواف الحجاج ببيت الله الحرام.
Because the way they deal with these places they go to is the way that the pagans and the polytheists dealt with their idols. They would do tawaf around their graves the way that the hujjaj, the people who do hajj, they do tawaf around the Kaaba. And ولذلك, some of them go with extreme. They say, I don't know if Asian continent, they say that. Well, this Somalia, yes, our grave worshippers, they say that there's a place within Somalia that if you go there, it's called Hajj al-Sughra. It's called the minor Hajj. It's equal to Umrah. You go, you do tawaf around the grave. Na'am. And you have done what? Hajj, which is minor. Na'am. Shirkiyat and kufriyat. And I'm guessing it's the same in other places. Na'am. Because every one of them, shaitan says revelation of them. All of this is wasawis al-shayateen. Shaitan sends revelation to the continent of Asia. He sends it to Africa. He's all over the place. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ فَإِنْ أَطَعْتُمُوهُمْ إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ
وَيَسْتَلِمُونَهُمُ اسْتِلَامَهُمْ لَا لِأَرْكَانِ الْبَيْتِ
They touch it. The graveyards. They bring the sand from the graveyard. They bring it home. And guess what they do with it? They feed their children from it. They take that sand, part of it they put inside the water, they mix it up and they give the children drink it. Some of that sand, they make the ta'weez out of it. They give it to the children and they put it inside there. يَسْتَلِمُونَ They touch it, they cry. Like how they touch what? لِأَرْكَانِ الْبَيْتِ Like the Kaaba, there are parts of the Kaaba which you touch, right? They do the same to the graveyard. They touch it. They cry over it. And they take part of the sand. Na'am. Even in the Kaaba, some of them try to rip the Kaaba's cloth. There has to be a police that looks after them, looks at them. What do they do? They rip the cloth off, they'll take it home. And guess what they would do with that? They would wipe it over their bodies. There's nothing else on it. People's bogies and people's tears and people's fall on it. What do you take? Now, there's a story narrated, even that they were not using it as evidence for our aqidah, but we're just trying to show you how dim-witted and ignorant and some of these people's actions are. How, wallahi, dim-witted they are. There was a man whose donkey died. And his donkey served him for so many years. His donkey's done a good job for him. And he thought to himself, this is not right. For this donkey that was with me for those many, many extensive years, served me. I can't just treat it like a normal animal and let it just die in the middle of the road. And then a lion or something comes and eats it. I have to show some form of respect towards it. So what did he do? He took his donkey and he buried it outside the city. He buried it. And he left. He came into the city. He came home that night and he slept. In the morning when he woke up, he saw the people of the city, a lot of them were absent and they were gone. So he said to the people, what has happened? Why are the people absent? Where are they gone? And they said to him, they've went outside the city and they're at that place. So he made his way and he went there. When he came, he saw people, all of them gathered and they were crying over a grave. So he recognized the grave. It was the grave which he buried his donkey in. So he came to the people, he said, why are you guys crying over here? They said, last night a malak came, an angel came. An angel came down. And he buried another angel here. Or he buried a righteous person here. He buried a righteous person here. And so there's a wali min awliya ilahin here. There's a wali min awliya here. He said, get away here, my donkey's in here. Wali min awliya ilahin. My donkeys. So a lot of them, مِمَّا لَا شَكَّ فِي Without a doubt, they are worshipping donkeys and animals like that. لَا شَكَّ Don't just, it's not غَرَابَة. If you ask them who's really in here, who knows? A lot of them don't even know. إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَىٰ أُمَّةٍ وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ أَثَارِهِمْ مُقْتَدُونَ We just found our forefathers coming here. They don't know. Man.
وَيُخَاطِبُونَ الْمَيْتَ بِكَلِمَاتِ الْكُفْرِيَّةِ مِنْ قَوْلِهِمْ
They refer to the dead with speeches which are kufr when they're speaking to him. Statements of kufr they are saying.
عَلَى اللَّهِ وَعَلَيْكَ
On Allah and on you.
وَيَحْتِفُونَ بِأَسْمَائِهِمْ عِنْدَ الشَّدَائِدِ وَنَحْوِهَا
They call unto the names of those people in their graves at times of hardship and other than it. Rather, our the ones who ascribe themselves to Islam today, wallahi they're not Muslims, who ascribe to Islam. And as I said to you before, al-jahlu, ignorance of this type of kufr, la yu'dar, is not excused. Ignorance of this type of knowledge, when you're in a Muslim country, and the Quran is there, and the scholars are around you, la yu'dar, you're not excused. So those people, the masajid of the people of the Sunnah are steps away from them. This masajid of the people of the Sunnah are steps away from them. They can walk. And they are passing it by. And they're not learning. And they're not educating themselves. And they're going to the graves. And rather they're shown enmity and hate towards what? They're shown hate and enmity towards what? Enmity towards to the people who are calling them to the Tawheed. These people are kuffar. They're not Muslims. They are what? Kuffar. When we're judging them, we don't judge them as Muslims. We don't deal with them as Muslims. We deal with them as though they are kuffar. They're not Muslims. Naam. لأن this tawheed la ilaha illallah is aslul asil. It's a fundamental point which a person comes into Islam with. فَعَلَّمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكِ. Know that there's none worthy of worship. The person has to know. Ala basira, has to be upon insight. He has to know what la ilallah means. Everyone has to know. It is fardu ayn. That everybody knows what la ilaha means. La ilaha illallah, you have to know what it means. La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. And that it doesn't mean la khaliqa illallah, wa la raziqa illallah, wa la mudabbira illallah. That ignorance, it is not excused. What do I mean it's not excused? As for us to refer to you as a kafir, there's no excuse. We don't give you ignorance as a mani'. It's not a mani' of making takfir on you on this issue. We make takfir on you, mubasharatan. But with the condition, as I said, that person lives in a, he's not hadith ahd bil Islam. He's not new to Islam. Second one, he lives in a place where Islam is being spreaded. He's in a place where Islam is, if he's in a land where there's no Islam and no Muslims exist and none of that, then la shak. The hujjah has to be established on him. Or he just entered Islam. Just shahada la ilaha illallah, shahada Muhammad Rasulullah, and then he went and he worshipped an idol. Just said he shahada. This time we explain to him. We sit him down and we say, look what you're doing. He's wearing a Christian sign. We take off him. We educate him. Yu'udhar. He's what? He's excused right at this point. So, this one who goes to the grave and he says, it's upon Allah and it's upon you, oh, the person in the grave. He has done what? Shirk. Allah, on Allah, wa alayka, oh you are the person of the grave. And then he calls onto, and grave worshippers who ascribe themselves to Islam are worse today. Why? Because the kuffar of Quraysh, as I said before, they only called onto Allah when? When did they call onto Allah? They only called onto Allah at times of hardship. Only hardship. What does Awan do? They call onto Allah, other than Allah, sorry. The kuffar of Quraysh, they only worship other than Allah when? Ease. Times of ease, they were worshipping other than Allah. At times of hardship, who did they run to? At times of hardship, who did the disbelievers run to? Allah. وَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ إِذَا هُمْ يُشْرِكُونَ. Kuffar of Quraysh, hardship, they'll throw their idols into the sea and say, Ya Rab, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. That's what they would say. Our grave worshippers, the plane is about to fall. He calls on to other than Allah. Ya Abdul Qadir, Madid. His wife's about to die, he calls on to other than Allah, even at times of hardship. Times of ease, he's calling on to other than Allah. At times of hardship, he's calling on to other than Allah. No, they're worse. No shaka wala raib. Every people of different continent of the world, they have their own person they call on to. Like there's all of the different continents have different ilah. Hey, listen, he'll tell you each country. Hey, yeah?
فأهل العراق والهند يدعون عبد القادر الجيلاني.
أهل العراق and Hind and Somalia, they call on to who? عبد القادر الجيلاني. Hey, yeah?
وأهل التهائم لهم في كل بلد ميت يهتفون باسمه يقولون يا زيلعي يا ابن العجيل.
ها The people of Ta'in, they call unto Ya Za'ila'i, Ya Ibn Ujaylin, and other people they have. Each one has their inner villages, they have their own qabr, they call it to that one. Hey?
Wa Ahlul Makkah, Wa Ahlul Ta'ifi, Ya Ibn Al-Abbas.
They do that.
Wa Ahlul Misr.
Wa Ahlul Misra.
Wa Ahlul Misra.
Don't put Alif Al-Lam in there.
Wa Ahlul Misra, Ya Rifa'i, Ya Badawi.
The car. They call it Raf. Ibn Taymiyyah argued with the Rifa'is. They came to him and they used to say that the fire can't burn us. So they used to try to burn themselves and then the fire. And they would have these anti-flammable, they would use that. So Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, okay, yeah. When they had an argument, Ibn Taymiyyah said, that night I prayed on the Qiyamul Layl, I asked Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, I said, oh Rabb, I'm going to throw myself into that fire tomorrow. Like in Nabiullah Ibrahim was thrown into the fire. I'll go in for your religion. Ya Rabb, give me Nasr and give me Tamkeen. He came to the argument and he said to them, listen, okay, we're all going to go into the fire, there's hot boiling water, we're all going to go inside it. I want you guys to do one thing. Everyone has to put this khal on, vinegar. And he said, I'm going to go in. They are, no. Because the khal gets rid of what they put on their skin. They would put this stuff on their skin and the fire wouldn't burn them. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, here's the khal, here's the vinegar, put it all on your skins, and we go in. What do you guys, is it called cider, what's it called? Apple cider.
Apple cider.
Apple cider, that is it. Put that on, he said. Pour it on yourselves, and then we all go in. They refused. He said, okay, what about, we put our finger in the fire, this much. Just wash this much, bitch, put it in. They couldn't put. He said, فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرْ Allah la yadil qawma zalimin. They lost in the argument. When Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah argued with them by hujjaj and barahin evidence, they were a people, the Rifa'is are a group of people who claim they have left the realm of ubudiyyah. Like they're not mukallafin anymore. Ibadah is not on them anymore. They've reached a realm that when you say to them, Akhi, u'bud rabbaka hatta ya'tiya lakal yaqeen, he said, this is for you guys. We are somewhere else. It's true, you guys are kufar, that's what you where you are. You guys are somewhere else, you're not. If you die upon what you're on. Na'am. So they left the ayah, wa'bud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen. So the people of Misra, ya Rifa'i, ya Badawi, they call unto. Hey?
Was-sadatu al-bakariya wa ahlu al-jibal, ya Aba Tayr.
The people of Bakri and the people of Jibal, they call unto ya Aba Tayr. And the people of Yemen?
Wa ahlu al-Yemen, ya Ibn al-Ulwan.
They call unto him.
Wa fi kulli قرية أموات يهتفون بهم
وينادونهم
ويرجونهم لجلب الخير ودفع الضر وهو بعينه
وهذا
بعينه فعل المشركين.
They say وهذا هو.
It says هو.
وهو. هاي فضل. وهو بعينه.
وهو بعينه فعل المشركين في الأصنام.
وفي كل قرية, every village, they have dead people in which they call onto, they yell to, they ask, and they hope from them what? جلب الخير, the good to come to them. ودفع الضر, and to rebel the evil. Every village, every city, they've got their own person. And then he said, وهذا, and all of that. هو بعينه, it is فعل المشركين, it is the actions of the pagans, the polytheists, في الأصنام, in idol worshipping. The Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala, he said.